thank you, Lord, that you have supplied all of our need, Lord. We honor you, Father God, with our gifts. We thank you right now, Father God. Oh, God, we bless you and honor you. We praise you. We stand in expectancy today for you to move exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or even think. And we thank you for it. Power belongs to you, and we worship you. You can do anything, God.
Lord, you're mine.
You can do anything but fail.
Lord, you're mine.
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 Lord, we can be soldiers of glory.
Lord, you're mine.
And we lift you up, oh God.
Lord, you're mine.
We praise you right now because you are.
Lord, you're mine.
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 Oh, Lord, how excellent is your name in all the earth. You set your glory above the heavens and the earth.
God, we give you glory, we give you praise. For you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and we bless your name. Song goes like this, listen.
No other God can be called a Father. No other God can be called a friend. No other God can be called a Redeemer. No other God's coming back again. And how we love your name, Jesus, you're the beautiful one. We love your name. And how we love your name, Jesus, you're the beautiful one. We love your name. No other God.
Come on, y'all got it. Come on, you got it. Come on, real simple.
No other God.
The next part says, and how we love. Come on, say.
And how we love your name, Jesus. You're the beautiful one. We love your name.
And how we love.
And how we love your name, Jesus. You're the beautiful one.
You got it. I see you. Come on. One more time, and how
we love your name, Jesus. You're the beautiful one. We love your name.
I see.
And how we love your name, Jesus. You're the beautiful one.
The next part is real simple. Come on, Jackie. Come on, say.
Say glory.
He looked beyond. all my faults and saw my needs. I shall forever lift my eyes to Calvary to view beyond all my faults. He looked beyond all my faults. He looked beyond all my faults and saw my
Mary lived in a town called Nazareth
and was engaged to a chap named Joseph.
One day, an angel appeared to her.
She was pretty scared.
Which is understandable.
He told her that she was going to have a very special baby.
He was going to be the Son of God, the Saviour of the world.
And she was to name him Jesus.
Mary became pregnant, just as the angel had said.
Caesar Augustus then ordered that a census be taken of the entire Roman Empire.
So Joseph travelled with Mary to Bethlehem, his hometown.
But the place was packed.
And they couldn't find anywhere to stay.
Well, apart from a stable, alongside loads of animals.
Ooh, stinky!
While there, Mary gave birth to the baby and named him Jesus.
Angels then told some shepherds the good news.
And they rushed to see him.
Magi came from the east with gifts of gold, frankincense and myrrh.
They all worshipped him.
Because they knew this baby was the long-awaited saviour of the world.
To God in a word of prayer. Father, we're grateful to you for this wonderful privilege this morning to share the word of God with your people. Your word is still a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my pathway. Illuminate your word. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Hey, I know you're at home today. Can you stand to your feet, grab your Bible, or pull out your device? Go with me to the Old Testament book, the book of the prophet Isaiah. Isaiah chapter number 9, verse number 6. A very familiar piece of scripture, but let me read it into our hearing and see what God has to say to us. Isaiah 9, verse 6 says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." I want to put a tag on this text, and for a few moments, let me preach from this thought. God has given us a special gift. God has given us a special gift. I'm a church baby, raised in church all of my life. One of my favorite gospel artists is a man by the name of Walter Hawkins. Walter Hawkins in 1998 penned these words, "Heaven sent me a wonderful, very special, beautiful gift. Heaven sent me a very wonderful, supernatural, special friend." Child of God, it was the prophet Isaiah who saw that gift that God was given, and he highlighted for us in human history that God himself, I like that, has given you and me a special gift. I shout early on that because some of us are still getting excited about gifts under the tree instead of the gift that died on the tree. And my mama said, if somebody was kind enough to give you a gift, the very least you could say is thank you. And can I tell you, thank you is a church word. Thank you is a praiseworthy word. And if you're grateful and you're thankful for what God's gift has given unto you, then can I pause parenthetically in the midst of this sermon and say you ought to give God a thank you praise right now. What did Isaiah see in Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6? First of all, he saw a crib. It says a child was born. Not only did he see a crib, but he saw a cross. A son has been given. But not only that, he also saw a crown. And he said, the government shall be upon his shoulders. Did I not share with you that that's Christ in a nutshell? He came in a crib. He died on a cross. And right now, he's got a crown. That Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6 is literally a letter within this chapter. It says, to us a son is born. Did you catch that? That God has a blessing with your name on it. His name is Jesus. He sent Jesus to us. He sent Jesus to you. Listen, that puts pep in my step, bounce in my ounce. That every time I need him, God will send him to us. When I'm down to my last dime, he steps in on time to us. When I'm troubled and don't know how I'm going to make it through, God sends him to us. When I'm perplexed and feeling in despair, God sends him to us. When my life is about to knock me down and in some kind of way my life is not destroyed, I'll tell you what happened. God sent a special gift to us. Verse 6 says his name is Wonderful. Yeah, his name is Counselor. His name is Mighty God. His name is Everlasting Father. His name is Prince of Peace. You missed your shout because there's Jesus in a nutshell again. In fact, Jesus is all of that. I would say, but Pastor, you ain't told me nothing. He's Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. He's all of that, but he's more than just that. See, Wonderful is his personality. His profession is a counselor. His power is Mighty God. His position is Everlasting Father, and his purpose is the Prince of Peace. You missed it. His name is Wonderful that takes care of the dullness in your life. His name is Counselor. He will handle the decisions in your life. He's the Mighty God. He'll handle the demands in your life. He's the Everlasting Father. He'll handle all the dimensions of your life. But check this. He's the Prince of Peace. He'll handle all the disturbances in your life. I said his name is Wonderful. Yeah, his name is Wonderful. When I fall, he lifts me. He's wonderful. When I fail, he forgives me. He's wonderful. When I stumble, he steadies me. He's wonderful. When I'm hurt, he heals me. When I'm broken, he mends me. When I'm blind, he leads me. When I'm hungry, he feeds me. When I face trials, he's with me. When I go through problems, he comforts me. When I deal with loss, he provides for me. I'm telling you, he's wonderful. That's his personality. But did you catch his profession? He's a counselor. Can I remind you, life sometimes will put you in the crossroads, won't it? I mean, sometimes you're like two roads diverge in a single wood. And I took the one less traveled by, and that made all the difference. Sometimes I don't know if I'm going left or right. Sometimes I don't know if it's this or that. Sometimes I don't know if it's left or right, leave or stay, this or that. And when I face those crossroads in life, and don't look at me strange, I'm not the only one who's ever gone through life's storm. I didn't know if I'm going left or right. I'm not the only one who didn't know if it's going to be this or that. And I sure not the only one that doesn't know if I'm going to leave or stay. All of us go through those times in life. But is there anybody glad he's a counselor? Yes, he is. Yeah, he was available for John Mark. He was ready to quit. He was a counselor for Jacob. He was a liar. He was a counselor for Miriam. She was a gossiper. He was a counselor for Thomas. He was a doubter. He was a counselor for Paul. He was a murderer. He was a counselor for Solomon. He was too rich. He was a counselor for Abraham. He was too old. He was a counselor for David. He was too young. He was a counselor for Bartimaeus. He was too poor. He was a counselor for Naomi. She was a widow. He was a counselor for Gomer. She was a prostitute. He was a counselor for Jeremiah. He was depressed. He was a counselor for Elijah. He was burned out. He was a counselor for Amos. He was oppressed. And child of God, if I didn't hit yours, then type yours in the comments. Whatever it is, he can deal with the decisions in your life. But also, not only is he wonderful, not only is he a counselor, he's the Mighty God. Yes, he is. Y'all, that's his power. You know, when you put another name on a person's last name, that's saying something. Alexander was called the Great. William to England was called the Conqueror. Ivan was called the Terrible. Lady Godiva was called the Freedom Rider. John was called the Baptist. But When you put that name on God, look what it said. He's the mighty God. You know what that means, child of God? He can handle everything going on in your life. He's got all power. In fact, that's what the old preacher said. He didn't get up with some power. He got up with all power. He's the mighty God. Let me hurry. But check out his position. He's the everlasting Father. I know we got to deal with some votes and we got to deal with some elections, but aren't you glad the God we serve doesn't have to deal with public opinion? Aren't you glad the God that we serve never has to run for re-election? The God that we serve, his term never runs out. I mean, he's a good father. In fact, that's the way I used to call my daddy. I said, my daddy's a good daddy. Can I sum that up real quick? God is a good father. He's the everlasting father. He will be with you every step of the way. In salvation, he said, come unto me. In discipleship, he says, lean or learn of me. And when you want to be fruitful, he'll say, abide in me. If you want fellowship, he'll say, come unto me. If you need a testimony, he'll say, witness for me. If you want communion, he says, remember me. In fact, you want to go to glory, he said, today you can be with me. Did you check all of that with God? He said, me, 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 me. That's personal pronoun. And God will give you a personal reason to love him. That's his position. But I got to leave you on this one. He can deal with the disturbances in your life. He said he is, yeah, the Prince of Peace. I want to remind you, that's his purpose. Baby child of God, brother and sister, you ain't meant to deal with storm every day of your life. Every day of your life ought not be cataclysmic. Every day of your life ought not be high anxiety. Every day of your life is bad. Every day of your life is filled with worry. You missing out the purpose of Jesus. He is the Prince of Peace. In fact, when he showed up in the manger, did not the angels form a mass choir? Did they not say, peace on earth, goodwill towards men? That's his purpose. I know somebody, you listening right now, I'm done preaching. And there you are, filled with trouble, trials, and tribulation. He's the Prince of Peace. You've got sin, stress, and struggle. He's the Prince of Peace. You feel defeated and demented. He's the Prince of Peace. You feel crippled and confused. He's the Prince of Peace. You feel wounded and weakened. He is the Prince of Peace. And so can I close it the way I said it? That God has sent us a special gift. His name is Wonderful. Don't put it together. Some of you say, Wonderful Counselor. Don't do God like that. He's Wonderful. He's Counselor. He's the Mighty God. He's the Everlasting Father. He's the Prince of Peace. God has sent to you, and you, and you over there. He sent you a special gift. Do you receive it? Do you receive the special gift that God wants to send to you and to you and to you looking at me over there? If you receive that, then put a hand up in that chat box. Put a hand up. Throw two hands up. Some of you ought to throw 45 hands up. Because he sent a gift to you. I love all the nicknames of Jesus, but I've learned to lean on him as the Prince of Peace. Storms come, don't they? Trouble has a way of creeping in, doesn't it? But I lean on his purpose. His purpose is to give you peace. And somebody watching me right now, you don't have to live your life in total disaster. Right now, there's a number on the screen. You can give your life to Jesus Christ. You can know him as personal savior for your life. You can know him in salvation. You can know him in restoration. You can text that number right now. Listen, it comes right to my phone. I will respond to you right now. You text right now, I will text you back. And I'm here to let you know that God will be everything he said he is in Isaiah chapter 9 and 6. It's as easy as ABC. Admit you need him. B, believe that God sent one answer for your life. C, confess that with your mouth. And then D, be determined to live your life for him. You can do it, child of God. You can do it. Then secondly, you're watching me right now and you're saying, Pastor Edwards, hey, I need a church home. I'd love to be your pastor. I'd love to influence your life. And then, hey, even though we're virtual today, you can recommit your life to the Lord. Right where you are. Yeah, I'm talking to you and you. And you hiding out over there. You can recommit your life to the Lord. It's easy. Father, I want to come back. I want the special gift that you have for me. I'm not going to get all excited about gifts under the tree, but I want to get excited about the gift that died on the tree. Jesus died for me, and I want that in my life. Can I pray for you? I see all of you chiming in and putting down people you're praying for. Who will you share the gift with this holiday season? Will you share the gift with somebody? I know you got gifts from your favorite department store, but will you share the gift with somebody this holiday season? Why don't you put that name in the chat box and let me join you in prayer. Could be somebody who needs salvation. Could be somebody sick. Could be somebody whose life is troubled, and you, that word spoke to you. He's the Prince of Peace. Could be somebody who feels powerless, and they need to know him as the mighty God. Put those names in the chat and let those of us who are church family join in with you and pray with you that you'll know Isaiah 96 is a special gift for you. Father, in Jesus' name, thank you for the wonderful way you remind us that you're all of that for us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Hey, I can't leave you without giving you an opportunity to continue to encourage and be a blessing and be generous to the church who feeds your soul. And I want to thank you for allowing us to come to you. All of this could not happen. All of this live stream and technology that we're using to broadcast on several different platforms at one time to make sure that you get a healthy dose of the Word of God. And I'm grateful to every generous and giving and committed donor of this ministry. And those of you who are giving for the very first time, thank God for you. Your first time gift pushes us to the next level in generosity, and we're grateful to God for you. Thank you. It's appearing on the screens, the ways you can do that. Please choose the option that fits you and do that and support the church that supports you. All right? Well, listen, it's time to go. Look this way. Let me bless you. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to smile upon you and give you his peace and your labor leisure, laughter, tears, when you rise early, when you settle late. May the Lord kiss you in the morning and tuck you in at night until that day. Well, the Bible says some will sit, others will stand at the very feet of Jesus, and there will be no sunrise nor sunset, for Jesus shall be the light of the world. Hey, he's a special gift. Receive that gift today. Peace.
Sing from above. so with our voices.
So with our voices lifted high.
Hallelujah.
And praises reaches to the sky.
Jesus, you're.
Jesus, you're the reason why. There's no Christmas without you.